the dates on here, like 2010, loads.
I'd say it's a bit freaky.
Look at the ceiling.
Mate, that just keeps going.
Jesus.
It's like some satanic ritual stuff going on in there as well. There's like candles like laying on the, site. It's so scary.
No way.
I've been Odyssey Explore, and I'll see you on the next one. Odyssey Explore out.
Jumping up and down the floor, my hat is an animal, and once there was an animal, it had a son that mowed the lawn. The son was an okay guy, they had a pet dragonfly. The dragonfly ran away, but it came back with a story to say.
Well, I can safely say this year's been a write-off for me, especially on this channel, and probably for a lot of people viewing, it's been a write-off for them as well. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys, the reason I haven't been uploading is generally because I've lost all lack of motivation for pretty much anything, really. My own fault, if anything else. I've just felt, especially like a lot of people probably have, that just nothing's going for me this year. I don't want this to be a depressing video, but I just thought you guys deserve a reason why I haven't been uploading. I haven't been keeping up to date with the channel. I haven't been keeping up to date with the Instagram, stuff like that. So I thought I'd come out and basically say what's happened, what's going on. Personal stuff with family really is mainly the reason why I haven't been uploading. My mind's been elsewhere. I won't go too much into it because it will be here all day, but I'm kind of a person that keeps everything to themselves. They don't like to express things. I've learned that from a young age really, but it's annoyed me even more because I'm always the person that's telling everybody to go out, do what they want to do, and pretty much live your life really. And to be honest, I haven't been living by my own life morals. But for the past couple of months, I've been longing for something that I'm struggling to find, whether that be with the channel, whether that be with a TikTok account that I've started where I go around and do little clips and stuff. But I think deep down, all that I really do need is to feel that sense of adventure inside. And I'll be honest, I haven't felt that at all this year, with everything that's going on especially. But I've been thinking for the past month, especially in December, that I've been saying to myself, on the 31st, I'm going to go out. I'm basically going to give myself a kick up the arse and kickstart the new year in a good way. So today I've come to David Stowe Airfield. I'm having a wander through the woods. We're going to walk in that direction, I believe, which will lead us towards Crowdy Reservoir. And then eventually I'm going to make my way around and attempt at climbing up Rowtor. Now, when I say attempt, I mean attempt, because I'm very, very unfit at the moment. So we're going to attempt it, and we're going to see what happens. If I get up there, I get up there. If not, I'll definitely make sure that it's one of my things for next year. Also, when we get back to the car, I have got something I need to show you guys. It was a purchase I made roughly about halfway through last year, and I will be doing a lot of things with it, especially with Sean from Love Sundays. We've been planning a trip, well, a couple of trips actually. We've been planning a couple of camping trips, but I'll show you guys that when we get back to the car. But let's get on with the adventure. Now, I will be honest, I haven't got a clue where I am. I'm just sort of wandering around aimlessly, really. So you might see some slips and falls while I'm looking at the camera. That's why I'm sort of diverting my eyes to the floor. I've been thinking about the channel recently, and to be honest, I've been looking at things on my previous videos, and I'm sort of not happy with it. It's not really what I want to be doing. This is more of what I want to be doing. There's a couple of YouTubers I used to watch before I started that inspired me to start, and their videos are basically this, walking through woods, going on camping trips, sort of just grounding yourself with nature. And I feel with all the shit going on at the moment, it's a bit hard to do that. It's a bit hard to get away from the trials and tribulations of society, to get away from all the crap. And I've sort of fell into that hole myself. Now, I know a lot of you out there watching this, if you are still watching this channel, you'll be thinking the same thing. And then gone. But it's hard to sort of think, where's the next step to go? And my channel, I want to be that. I want to be that sort of inspiration for people to go out and explore and have an adventure. And that's really the whole reason why I named the channel Odyssey Explore. Generally because Odyssey means a sort of adventure, and explore, well, everyone knows what that means. But yeah, combine the two together, go out and have an adventure and have an explore. But it's all about mindset. It's all about getting your mind in the right way, in the right frame of mind, to sort of ground yourself and almost take a step back. Anyway, rant over. Scenic shots. First part of the forest, but I think I've sort of hit a marshland. It's a bit squishy. We're gonna have a wander around here, see where we are. It's looking more likely I'm just gonna get back in the car and drive over there, because there is a car park for road tours just at the bottom of the mountain. But not the tour for all you Cornish viewers. It's just lovely to be out, to be honest, be out in nature walking around by myself. I suppose being by yourself as well, walking around, it sort of just gives you time to reflect and think about things. So this is why I sometimes don't like coming out on my own. I've been hearing non-stop screams for the past 5 minutes. And they're coming from the forest I just walked through. I don't know if you can hear that. Yeah, I think I'm gonna walk this way. At least I'm in the open now. Sort of found this road. But you gotta remember, this was an old airfield, so there's probably little roads scattered about and hidden everywhere. But obviously I have been here before on one of the old videos, which you can see is probably up here somewhere. Forgot where it is now, it's been that long. But don't go and watch it yet. Wait till the end. And then go and watch it. Yeah, I think I've given up. I'm gonna walk back to the car. I'll show you my little purchase, and then I think I'll drive over to Rautor car park. Otherwise, this video is gonna be like an hour long, I think. Right, guys, made it back to the car finally. I'm not gonna lie to you. I've literally had to sit in the car for the past 20 minutes with the aircon on because I'm so hot. I literally bought this coat probably 3 months ago, but I think I was thinking with my Midlands head on at the time, because it's not as cold down here as it is up in the Midlands at this time of year. I mean, I bought a bloody fold line bloody coat, for Christ's sake. I'll tell you what though, North Face ain't got nothing on this. If you want a really, really warm coat, go for Columbia, and that's not a sponsor. I wish it was, but it's not. Anyway, the thing I've wanted to show you is that bad boy. Now, I know it looks filthy, because I haven't washed my car in ages, so don't at me about it, because again, the no motivation thing. But basically, this tent box is gonna be my new little adventure. Again, not sponsored. So I'm gonna open it up for you lot and you can see what it is. And yeah, I'll give you a little tour. Of snow. And there you have it, everyone. Took me a bit of a while because I've completely forgot how to use it. Tent box. So basically, ladder pulls out of the top. It's sturdy enough. And then this is the best bit. This is the best bit. No, second best bit. You've got a little hanger to put your shoes in, so you don't have to walk them inside the tent. Walking around, you got a window there. You've got another doorway that you can open up, and that's there. And then you got one at the front of the car, another window there. Especially if you're on like a mountain or whatever, and you want to look at the views, you've got like sort of a panoramic view. Then we'll go up into it. I think I'll turn the light on for this. Hang on. Oh, there you go. So then you got your tent box, as you can see. Enough room for two sleeping bags. It's quite big, actually. Yeah, I generally thought it'd be a bit smaller than this when I first ordered it. So nice, it's pretty good. Good structure as well. It's solid, so you ain't gonna be blowing off a mountainside anytime soon. But the best bit about this tent box is this bad boy. Oh yes. There's a skylight. Obviously it's cloudy at the moment, but if you're up a mountain in the middle of nowhere, that'll be ideal for stargazing. So I have already been out in the tent box. Went about 3 months ago, 2 months ago, something like that. Me and Luke went up to Dartmoor, stayed out in Dartmoor, went and visited a nice little forest and that. Had a stone circle in the middle of it. I'll put a little clip of it up now. So yeah, I mean, little adventures like this is what this channel's all about. Sorry about the wind, by the way, started to pick up. And I think this is the answer. But like I said earlier, me and Sean, we're thinking about doing a couple of camping trips, because he's just recently modded up a little sort of camper van thing. He's sort of done it himself. He's bought the van, kitted it all out, got his surfboard in there, got the lot. He's gone full blown with it. I'll show you a little clip here. Thanks, Sean, for that little bit of footage about your little camper van. So yeah, I hope you like the little tent box, but stay tuned for more adventures with that, and they will be coming soon. But I think now it's time, pack it away, and then we'll head up to Rautor and have a little look around there. Right guys, I've just made it to Rautor. One, the car park is rammed. Two, the weather has started to take a turn for the worse. I don't know if you can see it outside, but basically the weather has got really bad. It started to be really windy and it's starting to rain, so I don't really particularly start walking up a mountain. And a lot of people now are coming from the car park and going, so I think they've realised. But now I know where the car park is, now I know how to get here, I'm definitely going to make this a trip, because this looks stunning. But yeah, I mean, as you can tell, look, I'll show you out the window.
The rain's coming in and the wind's starting to pick up.
I think we're going to give it a miss today, but I will go and find somewhere sheltered so we can do the outro. And yeah, I think that'll be it for today. All right, guys, that's a bit more of a scenic and sheltered backdrop, I would say, even though there's a massive gap in the forest there, but we have got trees above us. But I mean, coming across that road there, I just had a look back at Rautor, and you can't even see the mountain there. It's completely covered in water and rain and mist and God knows what. So I think we chose the right idea not going up there. Obviously you guys will be watching this video in 2022. I'd just like to say Happy New Year to everybody, and thank you for your continuous support through 2021. I have seen all the views tallying up on the videos, so you are still watching my videos, which is good. And also I've seen a couple of subscribers here and there. So thank you for joining the channel. Thank you for joining the family. And I promise I will get more videos out this year, 100%. I will be getting back in the right mindset, getting out in the tent box, doing collabs with Sean from Love Sundays, and possibly other people if they want to do a collab. I'm up for that. So yeah, stay tuned and we'll see what comes. Thank you again, and thanks for watching this video. Have a good 2022, guys, and I'll see you on the next adventure. Just on the way back to the car, guys, and I found this on the floor. It's a bit concerning, really. I think I'm gonna make a break for it.